So you want an easy way to understand what a command bus is? Well, I got you, because a command bus is just like a bridge. Think of a car driving across a bridge. It drives on the left-hand side of the road, or the correct side of the road. It crosses the bridge to reach its destination on the other side. Naturally, we now need to do a few donuts to symbolise navigating our spaghetti code. But once you're done, we make our way back across the bridge, this time on the other side of the road. Well, you would be on the other side of the road if you don't suck at video games like I do. This is a great way to think about a command bus. Our bridge is the command bus. The car is the message. The land at either side of the bridge are different parts of our system. That's one of the cool things about thinking of our command bus as a bridge, because they both genuinely share the same purpose of connectivity. A bridge physically links two locations together, while a command bus connects different parts of our system while allowing them to remain decoupled. Imagine if there was no bridge. We'd drive our car up to the edge and then we'd need to get a boat or swim. A bridge allows us not to care about these environmental factors. Likewise, a command bus also isolates us. Once set up, we no longer need to worry about the complexities of communication between system components. We are isolated from them and provided a standard pathway. Both bridges and message buses facilitate movement, either people or vehicles, or messages such as a command or an event. Now, let's solidify this understanding by looking at a bit of code. Here is a controller that takes in the command bus as a dependency. We also have a start method, which will create an instance of the start engine command and pass that to the command bus. From the outside, we have no idea how the command will reach the handler, any of the complexities. All we know is that we need to create a valid instance of the start engine command and pass it to the bus. If we take a look at the handler has no idea how the start engine command was created. It doesn't need to know. It doesn't need to know if it's an HTTP request. It doesn't need to know if it's being called from the command line. All it knows is that it's being passed a start engine command. Now, you may be wondering, how does the start engine command reach the handler? If we look again at our bridge, we could see another characteristic shared with a command bus. Segments. Segments of a bridge form a continuous pathway for a vehicle. Likewise, middleware within a command bus form a pipeline for messages. A vehicle crosses a bridge, encountering segment after segment in a specific order. A message passes through a command bus and encounters middleware, which are also in a predefined and specific sequence. Once the trip is over and the vehicle is ready to return home, it will travel back across the bridge, but this time encountering each segment in reverse order. Middleware for a message pipeline also completes their execution in reverse order before the operation is complete. Each middleware is completely independent. They are unaware of their place within the pipeline. They just receive a message, do their thing, and pass it along to the next. Well, unless it wants to abort the process for some reason. Now, all analogies break down at some point, but if you're just encountering a command bus for the first time, then thinking about them simply as a bridge can help you understand their purpose.